consist of the largest and influential group among the tribes in Tripura. They have their own unique identity, culture, religion, tradition, food habits, customs, which is still seen in smaller amount of practices in some part of the state. This community is spread in all the 8 districts. Tripuris love to prepare their own handmade garments from the cotton they produce in the Jhum field. Females are expert in weaving and stitching in various designs, copying from nature. Rignai and Risha are commonly used by women to cover both the lower and the upper part of the body. Males used Kanborok or Tapang to wear and Kamchili Borok as shirt. Tripuri women love to wear ornaments like any other tribes in the northeastern part of India. From head to feet, they used various kinds of ornaments made of gold, silver, ivory, bronze, and bamboos. Surang is used for hair as hairpin. Wakum is used in the lower part of the ear and toya to the upper part, while ganthi, necklace of gold, and rangutang, silver coins, are used for necklace. Anchilui and bobati is used as armlet and yastem is used as fingering. Kharuk is used in anklet. That's how the Tripuri women beautify themselves in various occasions. The traditional dress of Riyangs is simple but admirably suitable to their rural environment. The Riyang women are expert weaver who until recently used to weave at home different types of clothes for all members of the family. Nowadays, of course, mill-made clothes with beautiful designs and embroideries are entering into the Riyang homes. Their ancient dress is still largely used in the hills and interior places. Recently, as a result of a cultural awakening, even the school and college-going girls are sometimes found using the traditional dress in a little modified form. Dresses of the women are hand-woven cloth, tied at their waist and long-sleeved shirt. Hand-woven cloth is used by all women of the Brus. Most of the women still weave their own clothes. Their handloom clothes are beautifully designed and long-lasting. Among their garments are Rignai Borok, the Risha, and long-sleeve shirts. Usually men do not use any ornaments and the dresses are similar to those of Tripuris. The adolescent, youths, adult and old males usually use a broader piece of napkin called Ritupuri Chamare, a shirt called Kutai Tabarok, and a turban known as Kamkai. The Riyang girl and women dress consist of a napkin Rignai or Ranai, a decorative piece of braced cloth Risha, a shirt Kotai, and turban Kamkai Burai. During winter, all use a wrapper, which is a big piece of cloth called Ritra. Formerly, both men and women were fond of ornaments. Now only the women have been using various ornaments. In the distant part, ornaments were made of locally available materials like wood, bamboo, tooth, horn of wild animals and seeds of wild banana. Brass, silver, bell metal and gold have almost replaced the traditional ones. Women ornaments vary upper part of earrings, Wakhong, the middle, and Nabak at the bottom of the lobe. For the necklace, Riyangs wear 3 types of necklace. Lokoi, made of black seeds of plantain or of beads. Rangtang, a necklace of coins, and Ganthi, made of brass. Tar, which they wear as armlet. Yaksho, a bangle. Tar, a bracelet. Their foot ornament is called Binge, which is made of brass. The women use a hairpin called Shangai, which was formerly nothing but porcupine thorns or spine. The traditional dress and ornaments and the pattern of wearing by the Jamatiyas is similar to those of the Tripuris and many other tribal communities of Tripura. The dress of the men is similar to those of the neighboring Bengalis. Men wear dhoti, shirt, vests, etc. The use of kamchali borag is very common among them. Most of the Jamatiya women still weave their own clothes. Their handloom clothes are beautifully designed and long-lasting. Among their garments are dignai borag, risha are worth mentioning. The design of swastik symbol was a very common design in their dignai borag and rituku. The use of black cotton vest was also in vogue among their women folk. It is to be noted that the Jamatiyas prepare the color for their yarns in their own indigenous process. They prepare these colors by boiling the fruits, barks, and leaves of various kinds of wild trees and plants. The black color is made from the fruits of ashram tree and yellow from lentil fruits. They know the technique to make these colors permanent. But nowadays, due to the influence of the machine-made yarn, the previous practice of the Jamatiyas has been declining. The ornaments used by them were rangutan, Brindavan phool, balia, and sangyeyo. The use of strings of beads of different colors was also in vogue among them. Today, the above mentioned traditional ornaments have been abandoned by them and forgotten for a long time. It is now a matter of bygone period to them. Many youngsters of the Jamatiya community do not know the names of them even. Nowadays, Jamatiya girls use gold, silver, gilt, glass, and plastic ornaments which is available in the market. The use of risha is being gradually replaced by tailor-made shirts, brassieres, etc. The Noatiya dress and ornaments are similar to those Tripuris. The common dress of the male is dhuti borag and kamchilui. The dhuti covers the lower portion of the body, while the kamchilui is used as shirt to cover the upper portion of the body. The common dress of the male is dhuti borag and kamchilui. The dhuti covers the lower portion of the body, while the kamchilui is used as shirt to cover the upper portion of the body. Generally, these dresses are white woven by the women in their waist loom. The males do not like colored dresses. Dignai borag is the dress for the lower part of the body of the females, while risha is meant for the upper portion. Dignai is generally made of black colored yarn, but the risha is a combination of yarns of various colors. The females make their dresses in the waist loom. The men folk only produce cotton in the field, and this is their only contribution in making dresses. All the other details are done by the females. At present, young boys and girls prefer pants and shirts or skirt and blouse which are available in the market. But the elder generation stick to their traditional dresses. On the occasions of festivals and other socio-religious functions, the young too maintain their old tradition as an obligatory custom. The females are very fond of ornaments. They like necklaces made of coins, earrings or pashas, and bangles of colorful glass. Silver made of ornaments are mostly used, which are made by melting the old silver coins. They also use chains of small balls of glass and flowers. Each young girl must have a flower in their hair. They also prefer perfume. Uchois are mainly dwelling in the Dhalai and South Tripura district. They also speak the language Kokborok, which is of Tibeto-Burmese origin. They are the least in number among Tripuri tribes. The Uchois are similar to those of Brus. Uchoi women love their own attire. They love to weave and color their own thread of yarns produced from the jhum cultivation. They also use ornaments like those of Brus. They mostly weave with black and white stripes and black and red for their Rignai and Risha. Kutai Borok, Kamkai, Rituku are the garments they use. Uchois are skilled in preparing the color for their yarns in their own indigenous process. They prepare these colors by boiling the fruits, barks and leaves of various kinds of wild trees and plants. The ornaments of Uchois are similar to Riang's. Wakom, Wari, Tar, Yaksho, Lokoi are the ornaments of the Uchois. Men and women of Halam community wear short piece of cloth wrapped round their waists and hanging up to the knees. The Halam people make their traditional dresses by themselves. The general dress for everyday use of a Halam male is locally called Puidiri and Rituku. The main garment Halam female is the Rignai, Vrikam and Riya. Their ornaments mostly consists of various kinds of floral seeds and animal bones. Though brightly outlandish, necklaces made of coins are also fashion for Halam women. Halam women use Dankari Maduli and Kwarbet Benchai in their ears. Koloids are described as one of the sub-tribes of the Halam community. In early days, the Koloids would produce their essential cloths by weaving in their traditional looms after spinning jhum cotton by means of their traditional methods. But at present, they purchase colored yarn from market and weave cloths. In early days, like the Riangs and the Molsons, the Koloids would use necklaces of coins and beads, silver bangles and necklaces of plantain seeds. But as a result of changing in their society, economic conditions and influence of modernity, they have shaken away to use their old age ornaments like the chamatias. At present, the Koloi women use earrings, necklaces, glass bangles from market. Following the bangles, of course, they still use their own made traditional dress like Rignai, Risha and Ritra. A change in the color and specimen may be found now. Sometimes they also use saris. In early days, the Koloi women did not part their hair and so they could be identified easily from other tribal women.